structure was the subordinate courts. Subordinate courts were the munsifs and amins. They used to stay. They used to operate. So munsif and amins used to operate, and these munsif and amins were Indians. So they were local people hired for this particular purpose in the subordinate courts. Alright. And just above to subordinate courts, there was a registrar court. So registrar court was always manned by the Europeans. So Europeans were always there in registrar court. Iske upar jitne bhi the sab Europeans hi uske andar manned kiye jaate the. Third category or third hierarchy was of Diwani Adalat. Now Diwani Adalat was at the third rung of the hierarchy. So indirectly it was just like a district, you can say judicial system, judicial dispensing system or justice system. So that was system in Diwani Adalat. Then we were having fourth structure, that was the provincial courts of civil appeal. So provincial courts of civil appeal was also established at the fourth level. At the fifth level was the level of Sadar Diwani Adalat. The Sadar Diwani Adalat was just like today's High Court. So today's High Court of any state was Sadar Diwani Adalat. Only difference is that in Sadar Diwani Adalat, it used to take up only matters pertaining to civil cases. So it was only looking after the civil cases, not criminal cases. For criminal cases, there was parallel system, and there was system of Sadar Nizamat Adalat. So Sadar Diwani is for civil cases, Sadar Nizamat was for criminal cases. And below this, there was four division of court of circuit. So four division of court of circuit was there, that was looking after the criminal cases in West Bengal or in Bengal at that point of time. Of course, there were four divisions of court of circuits were created. So court of circuit was also looking after what? Criminal cases. But it was at the level of district. Okay. So that at level of district, this used to take up this particular matter. Now, see, the important fact about it is what? That the criminal matters or the legal issues at that point of time were dealt as per the Islamic law, were dealt as per the Muslim laws. So Muslim laws were largely followed by these courts at that point of time in a little bit less harsher manner. Ki pair haath nahi kaat diya, gala nahi kaat diya. To less harsher manner mein Islamic or Muslim law ko hi wo implement kar rahe the in courts ke dwara. Theek hai? Ek bahut bada change hota hai 1831 mein Lord Bentinck ke dwara. Now Lord Bentinck, what he did, he abolished this concept of the court of circuit. The court of circuit and the provincial appeal courts. Alright. So Lord Bentinck was a person who brought certain reform in the system by abolishing the court of circuit and four provincial courts of civil appeal. Alright. So this hierarchy was finally abolished with Lord Bentinck in 1831. Now in 1833, another very important year for all of you, this question can again be asked to you in prelims. In 1833, the Charter Act of 1833 made the Governor General in Council, as the supreme authority to codify a law in India. So the law making power normally is enjoyed by the legislature. Similarly, the legislature was being manned by the Governor General in Council at that point of time. So a question can be asked to you in prelims that as per which law or which particular act the Governor General in Council got the power of making a law for India or for Indians in India. So it was the Charter Act 1833. Fine. Last but not the least, very important fact for all of you, that finally in 1865 the concepts of Sadar Diwani Adalat एंड सदर निजामत अदालत लुकिंग आफ्टर द सिविल एंड क्रिमिनल केसेस रिस्पेक्टिवली. नाउ दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स वर फाइनली एबॉलिश्ड. दे वर रिप्लेस्ड बाय द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ हाई कोर्ट्स. सो द फर्स्ट हाई कोर्ट्स इन इंडिया वॉज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड इन 1865 इन कैलकटा, मद्रास एंड बॉम्बे. सो इन कैलकटा, मद्रास एंड बॉम्बे इन 1865 the high courts were established after replacing the concept of sadr nizamat and sadr diwani adalats. All right, so this is how the entire chain of events were completed. So all these four important pillars of, you can say, the entire British administration system in India were established by the governor generals appointed by the Britishers only. But the most important fact for all of you is what? Role of Lord Cornwallis. You can see civil service, Cornwallis. Police, Cornwallis. Judicial system, Cornwallis. So this question can be asked to you that Cornwallis played a role in establishing which all organizations. You have to remember only one fact. If a question is given to you in this manner, that Cornwallis was the establisher of the civil and criminal court in India, you have to take the statement with a pinch of salt, because Warren Hastings had already made the background for Cornwallis to give the judicial system an organized, you can say, form. That what actually was the role of Cornwallis. So Cornwallis established judicial system on an organized manner. That was his contribution. But the concept of hierarchical structure of judicial system like civil and criminal courts were originally given by Warren Hastings only in India. So these facts and figures are important, especially in the context of this entire pyramidical structure that I have drawn over here. First, second, third, fourth and fifth. Now these particular facts you have to remember. Alright. And accordingly, all these facts that we have discussed are going to be very much very, very important for all of you from your prelims point of view. Fine. So in my next video, I'll take up the socio-cultural policy, which is mentioned there in chapter number 4, then cultural awakening mentioned in chapter number 5, and then socio-religious reform movement mentioned in chapter number 10. So 4, 5 and 10, we are going to club it together in my next video. Okay. Till then, stay healthy, stay back there, keep studying very hard. Okay. See you again then. Bye-bye. Take care. Bye.